fellow mommies. This is Marco. I am here to share with you the necessities you need if you're going to breastfeed. I knew I was going to breastfeed when I got pregnant, or at least give it a shot. Now, I didn't have everything I needed when I started breastfeeding because I kind of figured, like, if I can't breastfeed, I'm not going to buy all these products. And then it's almost like you really don't know if you need that type of stuff unless you're experiencing these certain things. So, you know, a lot of times as new moms, we spend so much money, like, buying toys and all these different things, and you're like, man, I wish I didn't buy that. I wish I would have known beforehand. But, you know, you're always trying to be prepared. So even if you're a mom and you're deciding to breastfeed and you just know that you need this stuff, then, you know, get it. It's up to you, whatever makes you feel comfortable. So I was probably breastfeeding Sai maybe about a month or two, and I'm like, okay, my breast started leaking. So I'm like, okay, I need pads, like, because this is getting annoying. And what would happen is, you know, I wouldn't wear a bra at night and I would wear a shirt. So I would be leaking at night. And it's like, you pretty much feel like you're sweating, like you're having night sweats. So I was like, oh, I can't like deal with this on a regular basis, you know? So now, like, I have to wear a bra, so that doesn't wake me up at night because you're trying to get sleep while your baby is asleep. So Josh actually went out and got me these. Now, I don't know how to say the name, but it's pretty standard. You've seen this before. I think it's Lasina. Let's see here. And these are the nursing pads. These are 100 pads and they're medium. So let's see if I could. So it's like, it's got the two, it's got three drops for medium, you know, so they hold up pretty well. Now, I was using these every day when I got them, and I would say change it up a little bit, like, don't wear it every day because it started to irritate my breast. During the beginning, your breasts are really sensitive because you're pumping. Your nipples haven't really, like, stretched to the max yet, so it's pretty uncomfortable. So I would definitely get these, but try not to use them every day. Like, you know, change it up a little bit, take a break. Next, if you're breastfeeding, you want to have storage bags. So I eventually got storage bags. And they're by the same maker. These are, how many come in here? I got 25. So I usually produce about 3 to 4 ounces on each breast. So this comes in handy, like, if the baby's sleeping and you have a bottle ready for when he wakes up, you could put this in the freezer and save that for the next time. Because if you have a bottle ready for him when he wakes up, that gives you time to make another bottle for, what, a couple more hours. So that's kind of how I would operate and know when to store bags. Now, I've probably only stored milk up to about, I've only actually had about 3 freezer bags worth of breast milk. And they weren't all full. It would be like 4 ounces, 5 ounces, 3. You know, but it's better than nothing if you don't want to use formula. Just want to have backup, you know, if the grandparents are keeping him or the dad, or like if you're stuck in traffic and you only left 2 bottles, you know, he still needs to eat. So these definitely come in handy. And I mean, you've all seen freezer bags, but they're like this. And they even tell you on here, like, you just want to have backup, you know, if the grandparents are keeping him or the dad, or like if you're stuck in traffic and you only left 2 bottles, you know, he still needs to eat. So these definitely come in handy. And I mean, you've all seen freezer bags, but they're like this. And they even tell you on here, like, let me see, like breast milk storage guidelines. And this is very helpful, like at room temperature, your breast milk is usually ideal for 4 to 6 hours. So I would leave my breast milk out for about 4 to 6 hours. If I know I'm gonna go to sleep or it's been a couple hours, I do put it in the fridge. But let me show you how they look. So this is what they look like. So you can put the time, the date, the volume, how many ounces is in here, and the name. And then they have the ounces and everything here. So it takes up to about 6 ounces. So it says not to pass the 6 ounces because I assume that it'll probably leak. And when you so what you want to do is when you put your milk in here and you freeze it, you want to make sure that you lay it down flat in the freezer, because when you unthaw it, you want it to equally unthaw. You know, you don't want like cold points, hot points. You want it to evenly you know, be the same temperature. So make sure you lay it down flat in the freezer. So you definitely want to make sure that you get some type of ointment. I think this is by Medela, how you say it, Tender Care. This works really, really good. It's safe for you and the baby. This will prevent, you know, from cracking, bleeding, things like that. Like, I was using this when I first started and I kind of slacked off, and I kind of see why people are like, make sure you put some type of ointment on because it's going to be miserable. And you know, everything hasn't stretched out yet and everything is new, so you definitely want to protect from things that, you know, you can prevent in the long run, you know. So I hope that this was helpful. If you need any more advice or have any questions, please leave a comment below. If there's anything that you would like me to make another video about, please leave a comment. Thank you. Bye.